maps tell us where to go, but they are also a lifeline to the things we need.
It's very important to be visible on maps. We need to know where people live, where are the buildings, especially in informal settlements. That helps with crisis response, but as well planning overall.
Simply put, if nobody knows where you live, they can't offer you the services or support you need.
So Abigail, I feel like we're in a typical neighborhood that's really hard to map.
So in the global south, settlements are more informal. Varieties of building structures makes it more difficult and almost impossible to completely map out.
We tend to take mapping for granted, you know, especially if we have it all available in the global north. Getting satellite coverage of the whole global south is difficult. There's not been that much investment in those type of imagery.
The Open Buildings team saw an opportunity to close this gap. We did this by getting existing high-res satellite imagery and building an AI model to identify where buildings are.
The very first step in building this dataset is teaching the model what is the building look like in the global south in general. And we do that by having a platform where we can draw around the houses so that the model learns what are the boundaries of those houses. And then over time, the model learns from those examples and it's now able to detect buildings in rural areas and dense urban areas as well. Those footprints include the size, the shape of every building we've detected, as well as a confidence score, how confident we are that AI actually detected a building.
The first release was in 2021. We successfully mapped over 500 million building polygons across Africa. Missing communities have been put back on maps.
Today, it's an open source dataset with 1.8 billion building detections. That covers Latin America, the Caribbean, South Asia, and Southeast Asia.
It becomes a foundational capability for NGOs, researchers, government agencies to build unique solutions tailored to the needs of their community and people.
So Uganda, 70% of the people don't have electricity. Sunbird AI is trying to combat this by determining suitable sites for deploying green energy options like mini grids. But how do you deploy that? Which places do you select? So when we found out about the Google Open Building dataset, it was very exciting. And it gives you first a location of where buildings are. And then by looking at the sizes of polygons of the buildings also help you to identify whether this, for example, is a school or a hospital. And this is a good proxy for potential use of energy.
So it started with, we have those high-res imagery available, what can we do with it? And then we've noticed, even with this improvement, some gaps. And we looked at, okay, what other imagery can we use? Can we use Sentinel-2 imagery from the European Space Agency? That is low-res, is freely available and often updated. What we've done is we've taken 32 snapshots of a single place over time with low-res images and one high-res image in the middle of the stack.
The result is an AI model that can detect buildings accurately from low-res satellite imagery and is accessible to anyone in the world.
The advantage of this new dataset is that it provides temporal information. We're able to go back in time. That informs on planning and strategy, so policymakers can actually take action and plan for both the short term and long term.
So it would take on average 18 months to do site validation visits before a site is selected for deploying a mini grid. So with the new temporal data, you can easily identify candidate sites almost instantaneously. We know exactly where the people live and we can see how communities evolve and can make their livelihoods better where they actually live.
being able to see how cities and rural areas are evolving over time can really inform your planning and strategy. What this project is doing is closing the data gap. We want people making policy decisions in the Global South to have the same tools available as the Global North.
It's good to see this.
It's really good to see it physically after seeing all of the satellite images. We're actually now able to put this place on the map.
This is more than a technological breakthrough. It means being able to serve people equally across the world. After all, maps are made so people don't get lost.